The Tao of Self-Confidence, episode 375.
Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. Visit our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits. Well, hello, friend. Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. I'm your host today, Sheena Yap Chan, and today I have a phenomenal lady on the show today. She's a writer for Forbes, she's an entrepreneur, she's a speaker, and she was Miss Nevada US 2014. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to Lisa Song Sutton. Lisa, how are you today? Maybe you can fill in a little bit more about yourself to our listeners.
Hi, Sheena. Thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure this morning. So I'm an entrepreneur based out of Las Vegas. I've co-founded four companies here. I'm invested in several others. And I write for Forbes about women in business, women in entrepreneurship. And as you mentioned, I'm a former Miss Nevada United States 2014.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And Lisa, what's your cultural background?
My mother's Korean and my father's American. So I was actually born in Seoul in South Korea. And then I was raised in Arizona from elementary school onward.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And what would be your favorite self-confidence quote?
What I love about self-confidence is that it's really about how you feel. And so there's this great quote that says, always wear your invisible crown. And it's especially poignant for me coming from pageantry and modeling world. You know, you work so hard to win the title and really work hard towards a goal that you've set for yourself. And having that inner confidence and really letting that inner beauty shine through and shine out reminds me all the time to just wear your invisible crown and make sure that you feel like 100% in your best.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And I also love that quote, you know, especially when we have days when we don't feel 100%, right? We just put that invisible crown on and just keep going, because we all go through bad days. It's just learning to pick ourselves up is what matters the most. So thanks for sharing that. And in your own words, how would you define self-confidence?
I think it really is just a matter of how you feel about yourself. It's self-confidence, right? So other people's opinions really shouldn't be impacting that. It's truly about how you feel about yourself and, you know, your strengths, your weaknesses, and having that kind of self-acknowledgement and knowing about yourself and knowing what works for you and knowing what makes you feel good and makes you feel happy. Those are all things that add to your self-confidence.
Thanks for sharing that. I know for most of us, it's hard sometimes to, you know, not have our thoughts be run by others or not care about what other people think of us, especially, you know, growing up as an Asian woman. You know, it's like we've been told to just do whatever, you know, follow a route. And then it kind of it hurts us in the end, because then we end up, you know, so afraid that if we do something wrong, people might not love us or might not accept us. So, you know, I really like that definition that you mentioned. And, you know, what was your life like before your discovery of self-confidence?
I feel like I learned self-confidence pretty early on. I'm blessed to have a really amazing, supportive family system. My parents they're really loving, they're really supportive. And so I always grew up with a strong sense of self-confidence. My parents put me in everything under the sun. So I was in piano lessons and tap dance lessons and flute lessons. I was in all kinds of different skill-building activities. And they just always really encouraged me, not only to pursue that, but also, of course, to pursue academics and higher education as well. And I think through all those really positive experiences and excelling in those things, it helped build the self-confidence that I have today. But I think it just really goes back to your support system. You have to surround yourself with people who love you and care for you and really have your best interest at heart, because that's how you're going to be able to grow and be the best version of yourself.
Thanks for sharing that. And Lisa, was there like a point in your life when you realized, you know, you can always take the next level? You know, maybe an example is like going for Miss Nevada. You know, what was that aha moment when you realized you were more, you know, you were worth, you know, going out there and putting your all and just having that confidence to know that you're more than enough to go out there and do it?
Sure. I think, you know, for me, actually, I think my aha moment came after I was done with school, with college and grad school, and I was working, and we had started Sin City Cupcakes, which was my first company, and it was going really well. And we started the company kind of on a whim, and we were just so blessed to have really amazing opportunities come our way, and we were luckily prepared to meet those. And so I think my aha moment came when I realized you know, I could maybe really tackle this business thing and maybe start another company and you know, keep this momentum going that we have and continue to level up. And now, you know, 5 years later, that's exactly what I've been able to do. And it's been tremendous.
Thanks for sharing that. And I like how you mentioned, you know, if you can tackle one thing, you know, you can use the same exact steps to tackle another business and another business. And it shows because you've founded four different businesses that are doing well because you just applied the same steps that you did in your first business. And it's great to hear from that. And, you know, because of that, what's your life been like now?
It's been so wonderful. I am just incredibly grateful and blessed every day that I get to do something that I love, which is be an entrepreneur and be around business and be around business people and, you know, help others any way that I can. Like I said, you know, continuing to level up, again, it goes back to your self-confidence, right? Like you believing in yourself that you have the abilities and the strengths to do it. And if you don't know how to do certain things, you also have the self-awareness that you're resourceful enough to either partner up with someone who does or be able to reach out to other people who have more expertise than you who can ultimately help you along the way.
Thanks for sharing that. And I like how you mentioned that, right? Because, you know, a lot of us, when we start something, we have no clue what we're doing, right? We don't know. But I always say, you know, I may not know now, but I can always figure it out along the way. And I think, you know, that's a great lesson to learn. It's just like, you can just always figure it out. And, you know, the universe or whoever you believe in starts giving you that opportunity to just be, you know, aware enough to just take that chance, right? Even if we're scared, even if we have sweaty palms or we're stuttering or butterflies in our stomach, we just go ahead and take it. It's so rewarding after that. So, you know, to the listeners who's, you know, listening to your episode, they may be in a similar journey to self-confidence. What would be that one tip you would give to them?
I would just remind them that it's okay to be nervous and unsure. That's totally normal. And everyone experiences that because we don't know everything. There's no way that we can even anticipate everything. You have to realize that that's okay. But I think the people that really succeed and succeed well are the ones that persevere and maybe don't let it show that they're nervous or that they're scared or that they're completely unsure. There's a great quote. I think it's by Richard Branson who said that, you know, just say yes. Just say yes to everything and then figure it out later. And I think there's some element of truth to that. Even just last night, I co-emceed the Miss Nevada United States pageant, and we just crowned our 2017 sister queens. And, you know, all the girls, as you can imagine, right? They're super nervous. It's the pageant. So this is a day that they've all been working towards for, you know, several months and working hard towards this goal of competing. And I told all the girls that it's perfectly normal and fine to be super nervous. Everyone here is super nervous, but the girls that are going to shine tonight are the ones that just walk out on that stage and emit that total confidence that the judges will see, even though inside they're super nervous. And so I think it's the same thing in business. It's the same thing in life too.
Awesome. Well, thanks for that great tip. And it's so true, right? We all get nervous. I mean, even though I've done like 300 interviews, I still get nervous when, you know, I interview a new person. Like I still, you know, stutter sometimes or say the wrong thing, but you know, it's just you just keep going, right? You keep going and going because you know you have a bigger purpose to do something great to help others realize their true potential in the process. So thanks for, you know, sharing that great tip. And if our listeners wanted to get to know a little bit more about you and what you do or check out some of your businesses, is there any links or social media profiles we can connect with?
Absolutely. They can just find me through my website at lisasongsutton.com. And they can find me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at lisasongsutton.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And to our listeners, if you wanted to connect with Lisa, you can also head on over to the thetaoofselfconfidence.com and search for Lisa's name. Her show notes will pop up along with everything else we talked about. And I just want to thank Lisa for taking the time today to share her story and tips with us on self-confidence. So thank you so much, Lisa.
Of course, it was my pleasure. Thank you so much for having me on.
Not a problem. It was an honor having you on the show. And to our listeners, be on the lookout for another new episode of another amazing woman's journey to self-confidence, and we'll catch you later. Bye for now.
Thank you for tuning in to another amazing episode of The Tao of Self-Confidence. Want to learn how you can use podcasting to market your business? Download your free report by visiting our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.